My name is Mariam Jam and I'm the founder of I Am The Code. I Am The Code is the first African-led movement that mobilized government, private sector, and investors to invest in future technologies, but also invest in STEM education for marginalized communities. The best way to mobilize government, private sector, and investors was to create a movement that not only educate, but also inform policymakers, but also the private sector who are going to hire these people in the marginalized communities. So I created I Am The Code to give young women and young girls across the world a voice. That's how I Am The Code came about. Well, the initiative is now one of the largest ones across Africa and it's reaching the world right now. We're in 52 countries. So the way we do it really is to, in different ways, really create physical spaces where we create a safe environment for a marginalized community. So we have girls from slums in favelas in Brazil to La Villa Miseras in Argentina and slums in Nigeria and Kibera in Kenya. So we get all those people into a creative space, which we have across the continent right now and globally. And then we work with mentors, people who are local actors and agencies in government, also in communities, to bring them together to go and teach our curriculum, which is a unique curriculum designed by myself, which is a very simple curriculum to learn how to code. But also the idea is to improve digital literacy. We are not just teaching people how to code, but we're thinking about the 21st century skills that the marginalized communities will need to be part of. But also, you know, we make sure that they participate. Mission and vision was to empower 1 million women and girls coders by 2030. We have 7,300 girls that went through our program. And this is what we're doing, really. That's a real impact on the ground. We are the first organization that really touches marginalized communities. And when I say marginalized communities, I'm talking about young girls growing up in slums across the world. And I think as society, we definitely felt these people. I was felt by the society, you know, my society personally in Senegal. And so now I'm trying to change this across the world. We're trying to create alternative education, which these girls can become entrepreneurs. They can work for themselves. So in Senegal, we have girls building their e-commerce sites by themselves using local products. In Brazil, we have girls running their own coding classes, generating revenue for themselves.